Hello video editors, who understands the importance of hotkeys better than you? But are you sure you know the most useful ones for efficient editing? Today we'll walk you through them. Let us know in the comments which ones you use the most and which ones you don't. Let's start with the hotkeys that help when working on the scene. One of the most important keys here is Shift. It's perfect for resizing objects while keeping their proportions. The same applies when using the crop tool. Shift ensures your crop stays proportional. If you want to learn more about cropping, check out our video tutorial linked in the upper right corner. Next up is Control. This key comes in handy when working with curve lines and free shapes. If you add a curve line to the scene, you can make it smoother by holding the left mouse button. But if you want to remove the smoothness from a specific point, just hold Ctrl and double-click it. Want to bring the smoothness back? Hold Ctrl again and drag the point. You can also use Ctrl to manually adjust bezier handles. Just hold it and drag an anchor point. Ctrl is also useful for closing free shapes. Just press Ctrl, move your cursor to the starting point, and left-click it to close the shape. If a shape isn't closed, its last segment remains straight. But if you want a smooth connection, simply select the starting point and click the Closed Free Shape button. That's it. Now, let's talk about Alt. If you're working with multiple layers on the timeline and need to select one or several objects buried under others on the timeline, Alt is your best friend. Alt is partly connected with the timeline, and since we've already mentioned it, let's explore other useful shortcuts for timeline navigation. One of the most important actions here is navigation. That brings us back to Shift. If you press it along with the plus or minus keys, you can increase or decrease the size of timeline layers. Additionally, by holding Shift, Ctrl, and using the mouse wheel, you can quickly adjust the timeline scale. Once you've zoomed in, you can hold Alt and scroll the mouse wheel to move horizontally across the timeline. The program also includes an option to save the timeline scale. To enable it, go to Options, then navigate to the Timeline section to find the Timeline Scale Control parameter. This setting allows you to choose whether the program remembers the selected timeline scale for the entire project or for each object individually. Now, let's move on to the hotkeys that allow you to control the playback cursor position. The left and right arrow keys on your keyboard let you move the cursor frame by frame in the corresponding direction. If you hold Ctrl while using the arrow keys, the cursor will move in 1 second increments instead. Additionally, by holding Ctrl and pressing Home or End, you can jump between the edges of added elements on the timeline. If no objects are selected, the cursor will move considering all layers. If you have selected specific objects, the movement will be based only on those selected elements. By default, the shortcut for cutting a video in the program is Ctrl-K. You can also trim everything before the cursor using Ctrl-Shift and left square bracket, or after the cursor using Ctrl-Shift and right square bracket. If you want to change hotkeys, for example for this particular shortcut, go to Options – Keyboard Shortcuts. In the Shortcuts filter field, type Split into Parts. Expand the Timeline section and select Split into Parts. Then in the Press Shortcut Key field, enter for example K, click Assign and then OK. Now the additional hotkey K can be used to split a file. You can assign any other key that is convenient for you. The next hotkey allows you to create markers, which are useful for synchronizing files and effects. If nothing is selected on the timeline, press M, and the marker will be created for the entire timeline, making it visible from any part of your project. If you select an object and then create a marker, it will only be placed within that specific object. Now, let's discuss shortcuts for the key editor. The plus and minus hotkeys work just like on the timeline to zoom in and out. The same hotkeys for moving the cursor by one frame or by 1 second also work using the arrow keys while holding Ctrl. Holding Ctrl and pressing Home or End moves the cursor between keyframes. To add points, it is convenient to use Insert, and to delete points, use Delete. By holding Ctrl and double-clicking on a keyframe, you can change its mode from busier to linear. Conversely, to switch from linear to busier, hold Ctrl and drag the point to create busier handles. If you want to edit each anchor separately, hold Ctrl and drag the anchor on the handle. If you need to move a key only along one axis, hold Shift and move the point either horizontally or vertically. And the last hotkey we will cover is F7. Use it when you need to quickly open the Export Project window. Of course, there are many more hotkeys available in the program. If you want to learn more about them, follow the link in the description and download the PDF document which lists all current hotkeys in the program. We hope this lesson was helpful and that you've learned much new information to help you create content much faster. Do not forget to subscribe and see you next time!